The development of the B-21 is being carried out in near-total secrecy, with little information publicly released. The U.S. Air Force, USAF, has said that it is continuing test flights and production of the B-21 Raider stealth bomber, as the service looks to introduce the next-generation platform on schedule from the mid-2020s onwards. In a 22nd of May 2024 release, the USAF stated that since its formal unveiling in December 2022, the B-21 has begun flight testing at Edwards Air Force Base, where it continues to make progress, with the type scheduled to incrementally replace existing B-1B Lancer and B-2 Spirit, which are currently in service. The long-range, stealth platform is intended to offer the ability to penetrate enemy air defense networks to conduct strikes. The USAF's minimum production goal is for at least 100 aircraft, which are being manufactured by Northrop Grumman. During recent testimony at the Senate Armed Services Committee, Andrew Hunter, Assistant Secretary of the Air Force for Acquisition, Technology and Logistics, highlighted B-21 flight testing was on track to meet timelines, according to the USAF. "We are in the flight test program. The flight test program is proceeding well," Hunter said in response to a question about the B-21 program. "It is doing what flight test programs are designed to do, which is helping us learn about the unique characteristics of this platform, but in a very, very effective way." The USAF's Rapid Capabilities Office manages the acquisition program, focusing on making test aircraft as production representative as possible. "Test aircraft are built on the same manufacturing line and use the same manning and tooling that will be used in the eventual production," the service stated. "Rather than a traditional flight prototype approach, B-21 test aircraft are built, including mission systems, using the same manufacturing processes and tooling for production aircraft, in order to expedite the build process." The USAF stated that when the B-21 enters the service, Ellsworth AFB, South Dakota, will be the first B-21 main operating base and location of the formal training unit. Whiteman AFB, Missouri, and Dyess AFB, Texas, are the preferred locations for the remaining bases and will receive aircraft as they become available. On the 22nd of January 2024, the U.S. Department of Defense announced the start of low-scale production on the Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider, with manufacture taking place at USAF Plant 42 in Southern California. The program represents the culmination of the long-range strike bomber program, which began in 2011 to create a next-generation bomber for the U.S. Air Force. Analysis carried out by Global Data detailed that, adjusted for inflation, the per-unit cost was estimated at around $750 million, a significant decrease from the $2 billion each of the older 20 B-2 bombers cost, the platform it will be replacing. Economies of scale and improvements in stealth coating for reduced maintenance demands have helped to draw down per-unit costs, although the exact figures are held in strict secrecy by the U.S. military. Due to the platform's theoretical capabilities of stealth, sensor networking, and optional piloting, the B-21 is considered to be the world's first sixth-generation aircraft, the next step beyond fifth-generation systems like the US-led F-35 or China's JR-31 fighters. The US is also developing the next-generation air dominance (NGAD) platform, which is planned to be a true sixth-generation fighter to succeed the F-22 Raptor, among other platforms, currently in service. The B-21 is scheduled, by 2040, to replace the U.S. Air Force's 45 B-1 strategic bombers, dating from the 1980s, and 19 B-2 strategic bombers, dating from the 1990s. The B-21 may also eventually replace the B-52, which was originally built in the 1950s and is expected to remain in service for decades. The USAF plans to replace its bomber fleet and most of its nuclear delivery weapons, including its ICBMs. The Air Force is focusing Indo-Pacific operations around the B-21, which officials say is an important platform in a potential war against China. Maintenance and upkeep of the B-21 will be coordinated by Tinker Air Force Base, Oklahoma, while Edwards Air Force Base, California, will lead testing and evaluation. The B-21 is expected to operate from bases that currently house heavy bombers, such as Dyess Air Force Base, Texas, Dellsworth Air Force Base, South Dakota, and Whiteman Air Force Base, Missouri. In March 2019, Ellsworth was selected as the base to host the first B-21 operational unit, as well as the first training unit. Many aspects of the B-21 program are highly classified. The program is designated as a special access program. The Congressional Research Service noted in 2021 that technical details and specifications of the B-21, such as speed, support systems, size, required stealth capabilities, structure, number, and type of engines, weapons projection, and onboard sensors remain classified, although some information on various other aspects of the program has been made public since 2015. The first photo of the aircraft was released on December 2, 2022, taken during a launch ceremony at Northrop Grumman's production facility in Palmdale, California. A media report in 2015 said the Air Force wanted the bomber to also serve as an intelligence-gathering platform, battle manager, and interceptor aircraft. In 2016, then-Air Force Secretary Deborah Lee James said the B-21 would be a fifth-generation global precision strike platform with networked sensor firing capabilities. Northrop Grumman describes the B-21 as the world's first sixth-generation aircraft.